how Staffordshire should sound. Six Towns Radio.
What a tune, Concrete Jungle on Six Towns Radio. Roddy Radiation Buyers. And I've got the man himself on the telephone right now. Welcome to the show, Roddy.
Well, thank you very much. Cheers.
I've just spoke to you. Been doing a bit of gardening today. Not a great day for me.
Go do it.
Rock and roll. So we just played Concrete Jungle. Of course, that's one of the songs, the special songs that you wrote.
Yeah, I wrote that 1976, believe it or not.
Wow.
Before I joined the specials.
Yeah, because it's something you've always done, write songs.
Yeah, well, I started playing guitar when I was 13, so it's been a few years.
Yeah, and of course you wrote some other special songs like Rat Race a bit later on.
Yeah, Hail the Rich Girl, isn't it? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But you're here today to tell us about your band, the Scarbilly Rebels. When did that come into fruition?
Just over 10 years ago, you know. Played all over the UK, Ireland, Europe, and been over the States. It's my fourth tour next year, in February.
Yeah, because you've done a couple of other projects, including the one with Pauline Black that you did a few years ago, and
the Bone Shakers.
So, this is something that you've had for 10 years, and you're still getting strong with it.
I've been working on like the Scarbilly crossover thing, like a mixture of ska and rockabilly with a sort of punk ethic behind it, you know. So I had the idea back in the 80s, and had several bands over the years in between the specials, reformations, and still going strong.
Yeah, and Scarbilly as a genre is something that's been quite underground but still very, very popular.
Well, it was just like trying to think of a name which the press and people could latch onto. You know, so Scarbilly was like the, you know, a little term I came up with in the Face magazine back in 1981. I was working on this crossover sound, you know, which you could go back far enough. A lot of the early ska was wooden blues based, and if you hear a lot of country stuff, it's got that offbeat guitar thing in it, so it's not that unusual, really. It's always been there, you know.
Yeah, well, you say you've been together 10 years, and you wrote quite a lot of songs. You've sent me quite a lot, which I've been listening to. I've heard quite a lot online as well. Do you write together? Or do you have the biggest influence because you've wrote for so long?
Well, I tend to write on my own, actually. You know, sometimes the guys I'm working with will throw in a few ideas and that, you know, and same with the specials, where I write a song and probably be more rock and roll based, and the guys kind of put their bits in as well and make it what it is, you know.
Yeah. We met a long time ago now. A few years ago, you came up to Stoke to help out with a ska band called the Rough Cuts. It was still going strong.
Yeah, good friends of mine, yeah.
Yeah, and they brought you out, and I know one of the guys who works with them quite well, and he sort of alluded that you were in the bar. And I looked over and I thought, he is, and I had to play one of your songs. So how did that come about, that you worked with the Rough Cuts?
They asked me to sort of guest on their album, another week, another war. And I went up to, they picked me up from my home and went up there and did about three songs, you know. Chell Heath is one of my favourites we did, you know. It's one of their songs.
It's a very popular area.
Yeah, area of Stoke at the time. They took me to the local pub and I got to meet the locals. That was quite fun. And then I did a tour with them, around Germany and Czechoslovakia, you know, a few years ago, but that was great fun. It's like being on tour with the Bass Street Kids.
I can imagine, yeah. Yeah, they're still going, I think. I know they were after new members, but I'm sure they...
Yeah, they were looking for a new singer, yeah. I've heard, you know. Yeah. Changed a couple of times.
Yeah. Well, that happens. I suppose that's happened to you in some of your bands, you know, where, you know, people have got other things on or life gets in the way.
Yeah, sometimes either their wives get fed up and being on the road, or they just want to move on and try something different, or sometimes just sack them. Depending on, you know, where they fit in or not, you know, but it's like a family thing.
Yeah.
You have to spend so much time together, like, you got to get on pretty well, you know, to be cooped up in a van or whatever, like in hotel rooms, you know. if you don't get on, it can get a bit dodgy.
Oh, I can imagine, yeah. So are you touring at the moment, or have you got a tour planned soon?
I've just been weekends at the moment. Okay, so the next tour I've got in California next February. So I've got a US version of the Scully Rebels, because I couldn't afford to take my guys over there, like yeah. work visas and all the rest of it. So a friend of mine got some a couple of reggae ska players and a couple of rockabilly punks, and that went really well the past three times I've done it. You know.
Yeah, cool.
Went down to Mexico in May and played Tijuana. That was great fun.
Yeah.
We did the Ink and Iron Festival in Long Beach, or tattoo convention, and hot rod cars and stuff, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you write and you perform. Is it the two a labour of love, or do you prefer one more than the other? Do you like getting out on the road, or can you sit and just write songs? Does one please you more than the other?
Well, I think you've got to experience things to sort of be able to write about something, you know, like. So you get ideas from all places. Sometimes it's something that happened years and years ago. You just pull out the memory, and if you have a tune, you just find a title and maybe a chorus and then fill in the gaps, you know.
I wanted to ask you about collaborations, because you've said that you've got a band that you tour with outside of the UK. Is there anyone else you've worked with recently or you plan on working with?
I'm guesting quite a lot of different bands. You know, recently there's a band called the Sex Pistols, which are sort of a punk girl band who do like Sex Pistols, obviously, and The Clash, and they actually play some special songs, so they've asked me to guest for them. And I do quite a lot with different ska bands, like sort of Rough Cuts, Toot and Ska Men, Scarface, and I just get on a train with my guitar, and they sort of like provide an amplifier for me. But you've seen Chuck Berry turns up with a guitar and walks on stage and starts playing. It's almost like that.
Very rock and roll. I like it. You know what I mean? Just turning up and away you go.
Yeah, it's normally obviously the songs I've written with the special stuff. So it didn't take rocket science for me to sort it out, really. He's in the same key, which helps.
Yeah, yeah. Are you one of these people who will sound check forever, or are you just get in there, plug and go?
No, I'll have, two songs at the most, Then you can hear what's going on, and if you can't, you've got to imagine it, It depends on how good the PA system is,
Yeah, yeah. You mentioned the specials. We got asked the question. You've left now.
I quit in February, after nearly 5 years.
Yeah, because they came back and did quite a lot of touring.
Yeah, I didn't, like most of the guys didn't want to do any new material, and I thought, the Selector and Madness have all done new stuff, but the Specials didn't seem to want to do it, maybe because I'm the only person in the band who had any songs.
Yeah, that was always the thing. I thought that they'd release some more new stuff, because you've all got back together, except for Jerry.
Yeah, they didn't different mixes of different things, which is basically the same song, just a different take on it, But, I thought we'd try new stuff, but, some of the guys didn't want to do that, They actually said they didn't want to hurt our heritage, which I didn't quite get, I think they were just frightened if we come out with something that wasn't up to par, that people might say we couldn't do it, or maybe it was just a case of, like I said, I didn't want to do Scarberry type stuff, so, that was it, So I just thought I'd rather concentrate on my solo stuff, and Terry Hall was hard to work for because of his illness and that, It was getting a bit stressful for me, so I'd never would quit like the year before, so it's down to four of the original members, and when we reformed, that's without Jerry Danvers as well.
Yeah.
5 years ago. So, I think sometimes it was great fun, and it was great to play big venues all over the world. We did Australia and Japan and the States a few times, and it'd be nice if we'd done South America, but we never quite got there, but it was a lot of fun, to relive your youth almost.
Yeah, you mentioned Jerry Danvers wasn't involved. Was that because no one could work with him, or because he wasn't happy that you weren't asked?
We had a couple of rehearsals, and you know, we had a couple of meetings, but Jerry's always been a bit off the wall, you know, a bit of a mad scientist, you know. And I think his idea of reforming wasn't quite the same as the rest of us, you know. You know, he's got his own thing going. He's into more like jazz stuff, and you know, he likes to change the world every day.
Yeah, and I've seen Horace is doing all these art stuff, so everyone's got their own little thing.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, over the years, we've all done different things. You know, my band, and you know, whatever, you know, sort of. I went back to painting and decorating for a while when the money got tight. You know, like, sort of, that's what you have to do, isn't it? You know, to pay. Yeah. Pay the bills and feed the kids.
Yeah, oh, definitely, yeah. And if it did come up for another tour, you'd possibly think about it, or is it just game over now?
Yeah, they're actually doing a UK tour in November, but no, I'm not doing any more. No.
Yeah, I saw that.
They've got a new guy in, apparently. He's better than me and younger.
I much doubt that. So let's talk about the music scene. You've mentioned
you're younger anyway.
You've been in it since the mid-70s, you know, before the Specials made it, writing and all that. You've seen so many changes from how it was back then. You know, you struggled to get a record contract if you did. You know, you got back
the punk thing when that happened in the mid-70s, like there's always independent labels, so you could basically form a band and get 1,000 copies out of, you know, of an EP or whatever, or a single, and then you could go and play your neighbourhood bars, or you know, and it worked, you know. But it got tougher towards you know, the 80s, and the mid 80s was, you know, kind of all changed again, and now it seems, unless you're on one of these TV programmes, you know, like where you're just doing someone else's song, and what they call them programs?
Reality TV things, yeah. Yeah, basically like reality competitions, aren't they?
There didn't seem to be many sort of working class sort of bands around anymore. I don't know, they all seem to go straight from drama school or something, you know.
Yeah, well, I was born in 72, and we didn't learn music at school unless it was classical music. And no one had a drum kit or guitar. You sang hymns and things like that. And now it seems that
lucky, because the school I went to, the PE teacher was a drummer, and he used to let me and my band rehearse the music room and use his drum kit. And, you know, we actually played in the school assembly once, but we used to play the youth club and stuff like that, but you know, they don't. I don't know. Maybe they do now. For a long time since I've been at school, you know.
Yeah, yeah. And you were involved with the second wave of ska. I've discussed that already. You know, and that was.
Yeah, I suppose the first wave was like the original Jamaican stuff.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah, but like I say, like it did seem in the early 80s or. You know, it all got a bit samey. I mean, like, maybe though it's like the punk thing in a way. The original bands, original punk, big three or four, then it kind of got so like the songs weren't so good and the tunes, just a rehash of what came before. And it got a bit that way with the ska scene, where everyone seemed to sound like Madness or try to sound like the Specials or, you know, but the Americans had a good take on it. They kind of mixed it up with all kinds of, you know, hip-hop and God knows what, you know.
Yeah, yeah. And wasn't that something that you were interested in, making a punk band?
Well, I was kind of, like I say, mixing up stuff myself, like with the Scarberry thing, you know. Like, but I've always been into rock and roll, you know. So, like, when I joined the Specials, like, Elvis Costello told the band to sack me. So I'd lose a punk rock and roll guitarist, you don't fit in, you know. But, you know, I think because he just started listening to the early 60s ska stuff and didn't hear like Chuck Berry, Johnny Thunders kind of guitar playing, you know, which is what I was doing. But then again, we weren't trying to sort of do a rehash of the 60s ska stuff. It was kind of still punky and a different take on it, you know.
Without a doubt. Well, it's been so interesting talking to you this afternoon, Roddy, and we will definitely keep your tunes flowing on Six Towns Radio. We're going to play one more called Lonesome No More. Can you tell us a little bit about that before we play it?
Yeah, well, it's the only song I've ever written for my wife, actually.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a Buddy Holly scar, you know, if that makes any sense. Like the chorus kind of got that Peggy Sue kind of feel to it, in a way. And it's just basically an apology for, like, staying out late and drinking beer with your mates when you should be sitting at home watching TV with the missus.
Yes, I think I'm going to have to write a song for mine because, you know, she's struggled so much with being
an apology. With lots of chocolates, that works.
Yeah. But yeah, I do know what you mean. But this is going to be played now. But thank you very much for coming on the show today.
Thank you.
It's been an absolute pleasure talking to you.
Cheers, Terry, lovely.
Yeah, you take care. This is Scarborough Rebels, Lonesome No More.